Hi there. My name is Nico, and this is Michael, and we're medical students at the University of Michigan. In this video, we'll be discussing and demonstrating a cardiac auscultation. Cardiac auscultation is a really useful tool for getting a general picture of your patient's heart health. To do the auscultation, we'll use a stethoscope. This is a tool that you see a lot of times with healthcare professionals that help us listen to the sounds of the body, like the heart, lungs, and the GI. When you listen to the heart, there are some sounds that you focus on. The healthy heart sounds are the S1 and S2, or the lub-dub that Dr. Fox mentioned in the videos earlier. There are some other heart sounds that we want to pay attention to that should be absent in normal patients, but we want to detect in case anything's wrong. These will be sounds like murmurs or clicks. There are others named S3 and S4. So before doing the demonstration, I wanted to introduce a mnemonic that we use to find the different valves of the heart, and that is apartment M. So that's going to be APTM, aortic, pulmonary, tricuspid, and mitral. So to get the demonstration started, I'm gonna have Michael remove his shirt, and then we'll begin looking for the valves. So as you'll recall from the lesson, your heart kind of sits in your anterior chest, but more on the left side. And the valves have a certain anatomical location. However, when we auscultate, we're not actually going to be listening to the anatomical locations of the valves, but rather where the sound travels to in the chest cavity. So as I mentioned, the mnemonic we use is APTM. So we're going to start with the aortic valve. So the aortic valve is going to be in the second intercostal space on the right sternal border. So that's going to be right around here. And the way that I know that is I look for the sternal or jugular notch on the sternum, which is at the top of the manubrium, and I travel down to what is the sternal angle. The sternal angle is where the body of the sternum and the manubrium of the sternum meet. So at the sternal angle, I move immediately to the patient's right side, so it's the left in the video, and that is where I'll be able to auscultate the aortic pulse, or the aortic valve sound. So the aortic valve, as you know, closes at the end of systole, and that's going to make, so as a result, the S2 is going to be stronger. So you're going to hear more of a lub-dub, lub-dub. So that's the aortic valve. The pulmonary valve is going to be at the same height, but on the opposite side. So now we're on the left, the patient left, second intercostal sternal border. And so once again, I look for the jugular notch, and I travel down to the sternal angle, and it's going to be immediately on the left. So once again, that's an S2 heavy heart sound, and it's going to be lub-dub, lub-dub. Now I'm going to look for the tricuspid valve. And so I always remember tricuspid is tricuspid, so it's the right AV valve. But you're going to listen to it on the left side of the chest. So here's my sternal angle, okay, and here's the pulmonary. The tricuspid valve is going to be at the fourth or fifth intercostal, so just about a few inches below that, right around here, okay? And if I were to put these in, I would auscultate right around here, okay? And so, again, the tricuspid valve is an AV valve, so it's going to be S1 heavy, or lub-dub, lub-dub. So that's kind of subtle. Up here we said it's lub-dub, lub-dub. Here it's lub-dub. So that takes some practice to distinguish, but if you end up in a clinical setting, you'll be able to detect it. So once again, here we found our tricuspid valve at the fourth or fifth intercostal space on the left sternal border. And now the final one is the mitral valve, or the bicuspid of the left, or the left AV valve. And so that's going to be at the same height, for right about the fifth intercostal space, but at the mid-clavicular line. So here is your clavicle, right? And so right about halfway where it is between the sternum and the acromion is the mid area. So on males, you can actually use the nipple as a landmark. So it's going to be immediately inferior to it, right about here. So I would place my stethoscope here, and I would be listening to the mitral valve. And once again, that's going to be S1 heavy, so lub-dub. So just to review, apartment M is going to be the aortic valve at the second intercostal on the right side, the sternal border, the pulmonary on the left side of the sternal border at the second intercostal space, the tricuspid valve at the fourth or fifth intercostal space on the right, on the left sternal border, and the mitral valve at the fifth intercostal space on the midclavicular line. And one final clinical tidbit that we use is right around where the mitral valve sound is the point of maximum impulse, or the PMI. And we use this clinically in detecting kind of how hard the heart is working. So if I were to palpate here on him or on myself, I would be able to feel where my heart kind of rotates into my chest. And that's going to be clinically useful to see how hard the heart is working. So if you've just exercised, or if you're in the middle of exercise, you'll feel your heart really beating into your chest there. And if you can't, you can lean forward or to your left, and you'll hear it more so. And so while you're sitting down watching lectures, it'll be pretty soft compared to when you're exercising. So if you have a patient who's just sitting in your office and it's pretty strong, that can be clinically relevant. So this has been an introduction to the heart sounds and where to locate them on the chest cavity and the point of maximum impulse.